It's the official DJ Super Reefman, and welcome to part 5 of my Let's Play of The Legend of Zelda A Link to the Past. Well, let's see how this goes. You know, I'm recording with my phone, doing commentary, and playing the game as well. So, if all goes well, then I can continue doing it like this instead of pre-recording the gameplay and, you know, then doing the commentary after. And I've also got a fruit salad ice pop thing. Ice pop, whatever you call them. Very nice. Right, let's get started. One thing I will say is I tried to record part 5 yesterday. I did the commentary and the gameplay together. There was a problem. The commentary was perfectly fine, but the gameplay seemed to be stuck on the load screen. No idea. So it went on for like over an hour, where I was thinking it was recording for an hour, you know, the whole gameplay, but it didn't. So I'm hoping and praying that it doesn't happen again. But the very first save file you've seen, that's gone, but I replaced it with the very first save file I had to load and build myself back to where I was. Which you might notice I've got the flute now. I kind of done that beforehand. So I'm not sure if I actually got it in my part 4. But I've got it now. So I'm very sorry if any of you missed on that, out on that. But also, while I was building my arrows and bombs back up, I got to 70 arrows and I thought, right, let's try and spend another 100 and hopefully get another upgrade. But you only have get 58 bombs and 70 arrows, so yeah. So without further ado, let's get on with this. We are going to head into the second dungeon in a little bit. But right now, what I am going to do is where do I go? Where should I go? Ah, the shovel game. That guy that you have to dig up many parts of the ground and hopefully find some, or find a heart piece. We're going to try there. So let's head off to that place. And in order to do that, we gotta go into the dark world. And if this bozo gets out of the way, I can get there. And there we go, we're in dark world. How? One thing I need to check is if I've got that heart piece over there. Let's have a look. Yep, we got it. That's a bit more easier. Except for his head. I would have said, mind your head, before he bashed it, but I thought I'd say it after he said, you know, banged it. And I'm gonna die if I don't stay being careful. Let's see, there's a fairy fragment over here. Yay! Last thing I want to do is die. Get my trusty hammer. Get rid of them bozos. Ow. Thank you. Thank you, Santa. Oh no, I don't want to go that way. I gotta go down, then around, till I get to that area. Hopefully I might be lucky enough to, hang on, what's here? What was here? Give you something interesting. Oh, I've already got it. Well, see, I don't remember everything I got in my other file, so yeah, that's annoying. See if we can, well, see if we can get that heart piece. Now obviously this mini game is luck based, so you could get it, you couldn't get it. Let's just try. Where are you? Balls. Well, attempt number one has failed. Here we go again. Can I get a heart piece this time? Might try in the upper left corner this time. I will get it. When I played this quite a few months ago, I actually was able to get the heart piece. I was quite shocked. It would have been cool if I'd tried it the very first attempt and dug a few holes and then it pops out. That'd be like, whoa! But unfortunately, that hasn't happened. But I'm determined to get the heart piece. Give me the heart piece, please. I am tempted to look it up. It's got to be there somewhere. Come on, I got a dungeon to do. Come on. I know it's a ridiculous idea, but why don't I try and touch all the earth so you can see a little grass popping out or all the flowers. I know I've already tried that, but might as well try again. About them all then. Okay, maybe that's not gonna work. It's gotta be somewhere. If I can't do it within, let's say, another 5 tries, then we'll head straight to the second dungeon. Don't even ask how I did it. I have no idea. But like I said, it's luck based, so very fucking lucky. Anyway, before we head to the second dungeon, let's go and fetch something else. Now. I'm not sure if you remember what I said in a previous few parts ago. That I had played A Link Between Worlds. When I played that, and then I went back and played A Link to the Past, it was weird. Because my mind was so used to seeing... God. Well... I can't even think. What is wrong with me? The graphics. Like, because everything used to stand out in the 3D one. It was like, whoa. Like a dramatic change. Bet you're wondering, why are you going this way? Well, I'm gonna see if I can get the second medallion. It should be Quake? Or it might be the, well, yeah, there's another one that you get. choices. No, useless. What?
Have you got a few biscuits I can have?
A what?
A few biscuits.
Yeah, they're downstairs.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Right, we should be able to get this medallion. Obviously, if all goes well. So pick this up and throw it in there. There it is. Was it you who disturbed my peaceful nap? I will give this to you if you go away. Quick medallion. I think the wrapper of the ice, you know, pole just cut my mouth. Fucker. Let's see if there's any entrance in here. Well, see, Link Between Worlds is affecting my mind. What about here? No? Come on, get in the... I swear that was a purple. Okay, so where have we ended up? Oh, here. Well, that's not a bad thing, to be honest. Because we just need to land here. To get a heart piece. Okay, so a while ago, when I played this game, after I played A Link Between Worlds, you're gonna laugh at this, but I actually came down here and thought, okay, let's go in here and see Mother Mai Mai. And then I was like, oh. I still sometimes think of that. Like going to areas that I went to in A Link Between Worlds, not this. Let's see if we got a fairy in our house. Nope, just hearts. Now the way to start out the second dungeon is pretty straightforward. admit that fruit salad ice pop is nice. Right, so the way to get this started, most of you probably already know this anyway, but for those of you that don't, oh, fucking hell. I gotta go to the dark world first, don't I? Ow. Actually, something just come to my mind. And I'm gonna investigate. You know the lumberjacks? Or the guys sawing down a tree? Well, that was lucky. I was even more luckier. Well, anyway, gonna see if they've hacked that tree down now. They have! Yes! Let's go knock it down. And claim a heart piece, or piece of heart. But first, let's just check. Okay. There we are. We got one more piece to find. Whew. Well, one more piece to finish that container. I'm not sure there'll be others. Little shits. Surprise, motherfucker. Oh yeah, in this save file that I'm using right now, obviously it's not the same one as it was in part 4. It is the same one that was for part 3. So I've already done the Chris Houlihan room. I'm pretty sure I've got that on one of the videos. But yeah. Hopefully we don't have any more fuck ups. Sorry for swearing so much, but it really drives me nuts when stuff like that happens. Because all I want to do is be able to get this playthrough done and be able to go on to the next. Obviously that can't be done if... Ooh. Okay, that didn't work. Ooh, what's this? Ooh. we got 300 rupees. Thank you. Must be in there. Rupees. 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 I was hoping there'd be a heart piece there. A piece of heart, might we call it. Now, is there actually anything over here? That's what I'm wondering. No. Ooh, the little shed. Right, so then once we've gone through here, because this is how you can do the second dungeon. Now, Paul. Excuse, no, magic. Ooh. There we go. And now that the aqueducts are full of water, we can now head to Dark World and do the dungeon. And before I do this, sorry about this. Before I do this dungeon, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go downstairs, get another ice pot, and then come back and then be ready. So I'll see you in a minute. And I'm back. Right. Put my earphones back in. So I can hear it again. And the ice pop I have this time is cola cubes. Absolutely beautiful. Okay. Let's get going. Right, so there's nothing there. I do actually like this dungeon. The one dungeon I do fear might actually be a surprise, but it's the third dungeon. That place always confuses me. But then again, the ice dungeon is a bit of a git, so I'm probably agreeing with everyone else who hates that dungeon, because I do as well. Now you could try and charge the wall, but it won't break. Sunder, well, in Sunders, a map. Yay! Thank you. Needed that extra bit of life. Managed to time it just, you know, a bit too early. Ba ba. Color cubes are very nice. Oh yeah. What's through here? Absolutely nothing. Okay. Pull this lever. And yeah, make sure you do get the key before doing that. Because otherwise you'd be stuck. God damn it, I'm taking too much damage. Just like before, make sure you, I think there's a key, yeah, make sure you get the key first. And you can't push those blocks because they're literally locked in place. Open that door. Hey, that works. What?
Have you got anything else to plug into that speaker?
Why?
Because I need the thing for my phone to charge.
Take the charger from there.
You sure?
Yeah. Like always, my mother audio bombed my let's play. I don't know how she manages to do it. Okay, maybe we've opened that water away. Just trying to get a bit more. This cooler cube. Fucking nice that was. Actually, I don't want. I don't want that. I remember rightly, I gotta keep it the blue up and the red down. Before I get hurt. Yeah, that's the reason why you gotta have it red down, is because on the right side you need to get there to get a master key or a boss key. Is either called the master key or is the big boss key? Fall down here this on this side first. Once we really got some movies. Didn't make any sense. It says big key, then it goes, this is the master key. Why didn't you just say this is the master key? Okay, so let's go and claim the hook shot. Very helpful. Now that wasn't even planned. So, quite a lucky jump, fellas. And lucky reaction time. I think I know how to do this. Now we just bring this out. Ow. Oh. rupees and more rupees. And what's up here? Hey? Did you see that? It wasn't even like properly out. That was a glitch. Okay, so we've now gone full circle. We haven't missed any rooms out. What's the point in these? That's no secret. And what's in here? Oh, isn't that kind? They gave me two of those things. Okay. So. Ah, come on. How does that not hurt the enemy? Right, so we're gonna be heading to the boss in a minute. Just through this door, so let's get the hookshot ready. And here we go. I'm probably gonna die and obviously use one fairy, but should be fine. Got two more of those puffy thingies. Pieces of popcorn. Thank you. I was planning to use at least one fairy. How? Well, that dungeon number two done. Oh yeah. DGSR, because of you, I can escape from the clutches of the evil monsters. Thank you. The Triforce will grant the wishes of whoever touches it, as long as that person lives. That is why it was hidden in the Golden Land. Only a select few knew of its location. But at some point, that knowledge was lost. The person who rediscovered the Golden Land was none other than the evil king, Ganondorf, the evil thief. Luckily, he couldn't figure out how to return to the world of light, or the light world. Well, remember that you have magical powers, which only the hero can make you the most of. There are some other magical warping points, like the one you saw on Death Mountain. By using them, you can go between the two worlds and find the evils hidden in the Dark World. You are the only one who can destroy Ganondorf, the thief. No, Ganon, the evil king of darkness. Do you understand?
Yes.
May the way of the hero lead to the Triforce. You know, just the way Link usually responds to things. Nods his head and goes, Right. How much have we got? Well, we're almost reaching an hour now. So, what should I do for that remainder of time? You know what? Why not head towards... Not that way. Actually, yeah, this one. Let's go to the light world. Head to Death Mountain and claim the third medallion thingy. Yeah, the spell. That way we have all the spells. And I might even be a daredevil to try and get the Rod of Samaria thing it is. Wasn't that nice of that soldier just to give me the time to bowls. Actually, I have the. Oh, I haven't activated the bird yet, have I? Oh, I can do that in a bit. Right, yeah, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to get that medallion, then brave it and try and get that rod. Or some area, I think it's called. And then trying to think. Oh yeah, and then activate that statue bird thing. So then we can fly everywhere. Imagine that, Link growing some wings. It'd be like, what is his name? Heimlich from A Bug's Life. He's like, I am a beautiful butterfly! Piss off. Right, let's head here. So then we can get to that rod. No, not rod. The spell first. And then I'll re-enter the dark world. And then jump down. And attempt to get the rod on that man of life. Well. Oh, I need the book, don't I? Ether.
Ether. You have the Ether medallion.
Right, I'm not too sure if there's a fairy fountain here. If there is, then I'm gonna be very happy. No, it's not on that side. So let's head over here. Ah, what's down there? Fairy fountain. I would save, but if I do, then be like, bye bye. Right. Right. I keep saying right. It's like telling myself to shut up. Oh no. Don't tell me I have to have the big power glove thingy. Oh man. If I have to have that big power glove, I'm going to be annoyed. Oh yes! Thank God! Hey, we got the thingy. Mm-hmm. King of Burn or Bind, whatever it is. Well, how about that? Well, we got that king now. Try something. There. Okay, let's see what's through these doors. That one, these do nothing. Brilliant. And this one. So that's how I get through there. Bombs. Arrows. Where's the heart piece? Or a piece of heart. It's gotta be in here. Thank you. I swear, if it's just rupees, then that is a joke. What the f- That is ridiculous. So this time I'm not gonna go drop down. Ooh, fairy. Okay. Right, so I have dropped that down to that one. Which one should I jump down? This one? Phew. So that led nowhere. So I need to drop down this hole. Okay, seriously, what is the point in that room? Is there any point in me doing that? Oh, hang on. I haven't seen this room before. I don't know which one to jump down. This one? Do they lead anywhere? That's the question. And probably the answer is no. Still, I guess it doesn't hurt to find out. Nah, there is nothing here. I'm just wasting my time. Well, I've been through that one. Pretty sure there is no more holes or no reason to jump down anymore. Or is there? There's nothing here. Oh, I came through there, didn't I? There's nothing there. We're gonna go and quickly do that bird thing. And now we have Mr. Birdie. Okay. Well, thank you for watching. And I will see you in part 6. So thank you for watching this video. In part 6, we will take on the third dungeon. Which might be Skull Woods. So as I said just now, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Let me just say first, thank you and goodbye.